Now that we understand a bit about templates and modes, let's walk through creating our own template. So the first thing you need to do when you want to create a new template is go over here to your templates and click the Create New button. I'm just going to select the basic human as my starter template, and I'm going to call this Demo. I'm going to save the meta rig, and then I'm going to go and convert it to control mode. You can see here is our Rigify rig, but nothing is attached and nothing is in the right positions. Let's go to edit the meta rig. What we need to do is remove the bones that we don't need. X-axis mirroring is already turned on in this mode, so if I delete this, it'll go ahead and delete the bones on the other side. Same thing with positioning. And also snapping to a single vertice is turned on, so it'll snap to the endpoints of each bone, which is convenient. So to keep this demo short, I'm just going to create the mapping for an arm. Here I don't have anything to snap to, so I'm just going to move this about to the center of the hand. Now that I have my bones in the correct position, I'm going to go ahead and switch over to FK to source mode. When I'm in this mode, it's really nice to have an animation. That way I can see how the animation is being constrained to the Rigify rig. So for example, if I go ahead and I just select this bone, which I can see right here is called upper arm dash L, and I select this bone, and I do Alt 1, I get this pie menu. I'm going to do link selected bones. What this just did is it snapped my Rigify rig to my source rig, and now it's matching that animation. And you can see that these two nodes have been created. I'm going to go ahead and just undo this link. I'm just going to delete these nodes. What I want to show you here is this X-axis mirror feature. You can actually mirror your constraints based on a name token. So for this particular rig, we can see that its naming convention has an underscore L for the left and an underscore lowercase r for the right. So let's just go ahead and put those in. Underscore L for the left, underscore r for the right. Once that's linked, let's just go ahead and do that exact same thing again. I'm going to select the upper arm L, and I'm going to select this upper arm FK.L for the Rigify rig. And I'm just going to hit Alt 1 to pull up my pie menu. I'm going to hit Link Selected Bones. Now you can see that I have both the left and the right created. I'm going to do the same thing for these bones. And then finally, the wrist. Now, what I like to do is I like to organize these nodes so when I come back to them or when another user comes back to them, they're easy to understand. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select all these bones on this side and I'm going to hit Combine Selected Nodes. I'm going to hit F2 and I'm going to call this Control Rig Arm. So essentially all the bones listed here are the control rig, which is just our Rigify rig, and that is both the left and right arms. So I might just call this arms. And then I'm going to combine these. And I'm going to call this source rig arms. And in this way, you can organize your node tree and keep things orderly for when you have to come back and make modifications to them. I'm going to go ahead and move on to the source of the form mode. In this mode, our animation should gradually snap to these deformation bones. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to select this upper arm L, and I'm going to link it to this upper arm def. Also, this upper arm twist can be linked to this def as well. I'm going to link this source bone to this Rigify def bone, this twist bone, and then this wrist bone. And now you should see that our source rig is gradually being constrained to the rest pose of the Rigify rig. I do want to show you one other feature. If I was to box select several bones like this, and I was to hit Alt 1, and I use nodes from selected bones rather than link selected bones, you can see what this does is it basically creates your source bones on the left and then your deformed bones on the right. It doesn't create any links between them, but it basically makes all the sockets necessary for your selection of bones. So if you want to work that way, you could do that as well. Another thing you can do is you can actually add bones by their name instead of using the pie menu. So to demonstrate this, I'm just going to unlink these bones right here, which is just the def forearm and the lower arm L. So if I just delete these nodes, you can see that we no longer have this link. But let's say I wanted to add these bones in by their name. I can search for these bones by hitting Shift A, and I can select them from this drop down here, or I can just use the search, which I'm going to search for lower arm L. I'm going to add that, and then I'm going to search for forearm L. And link that. In the same way, I could search for the right and link that up as well. I'm going to move on to control mode. In control mode, you can see that we have our rig mapped. What I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to switch back to source mode. I'm just going to select this option, overwrite animation. That way, if we have any animation data, it'll always overwrite what's on the control rig. I'm going to switch back to control mode, and now you can see that we have our arms and their animation copied over. You can see that our rig doesn't match up entirely because we only did the arms, but it's the exact same process to map the rest of the skeleton. You can see now that we have arms with keyframes on them, and also these arms are able to be controlled by our Rigify controls. One other thing I want to show you is how you can edit Rigify types after you've already created your skeleton. So let's say we wanted to change the Rigify type on this arm here. Let's go to Edit MetaRig. Let's switch over to Pose Mode. And then you can see that we can select the Rigify type. For more information on this, consult the Rigify documentation. But for now, I'm just going to take this super limb and I'm going to change it to a simple tentacle. Now, after we do this, we needed to make some changes to our mappings. So I'm going to go to Source to Deform, and you can see right here that we have a simple tentacle, which is just a three-bone chain, and then this super arm actually has the twist bones in it. So this is a little different. I'm just going to unlink the bones on the left. And then I'm going to turn off x-axis mirroring, and I'm going to select this bone and this bone. And finally that bone. Now if we go over to control mode, we can see that this arm is now following the tentacle control scheme. So you can rapidly switch out different Rigify types and experiment with different rig samples and create the mappings that you need to make these work with your original source rig. This is essentially the process that you have to go through to create your own templates for your own unique rigs.